All right. Well, first order of business here is I've caught myself a brown recluse. And there he is. He's a pretty small one compared to the ones I've seen around here. I was gonna kill him, but I decided maybe I'll keep him as a pet, you know? Make a good pet. Anyway, second order of business is people keep saying that my T500 is a 500 watt amplifier, which is true. But as most people know, Rockfords are underrated, most of them, and they come with a brush sheet that gives out their power ratings. And here you go, 741 watts RMS at 1 ohm. There's some more specs. Here's the graph. 80 hertz, 741 watts, total RMS power. So there you go. That is for my 500 watt T500. All right. Right over there. Don't give a fuck about that. Yeah, look at this little bastard trying to climb up the fucking side now. Look at him go. No, motherfucker. You fucking picked the wrong garage. Alright, second order of business is, bring my flashlight with me. I can't for the life of me find a fucking tape measure, so we're gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. Buddy of mine, Eric. I think it's Eric Mattson. Whatever his last name is, Eric M. something, 19 something, some odd numbers on YouTube showed me a good place to find wire. It's knuconcepts.com with a Z, Z and a K. They've got 1-aught cables. They have their own brand of wire, it looks like. So I don't know if their wire is any good or not, but it's pretty cheap. They sell 1-aught by the foot for $3 and $3.75 or something like that per foot. So I thought that was a pretty good deal for 1-aught copper. I'm tripping out. They sell 50-foot rolls for 160 bucks, but instead of dropping some huge bank on a 100 or 50 feet of it, I'm gonna go ahead and measure out how much I need for my car. It's gonna be wrong on that side. Open my head. Is actually harder to do with one hand. My alternator is right there. It's 115 amp, is what it is. So it's not 120, it's 115. I also might, they sell alternators on that website as well, so I also might be picking up an alternator from them. If I request, I sent an email requesting a 225 amp alternator for a Mercedes with my engine. You see the power wire right there. It looks, that's a lot smaller than a 5 gauge. That's like, that's not even 5 gauge power wire, man. I can drop some 5 gauge in there right now and it'll be better than what's in there. What the hell? They got some tiny ass wires, man. No wonder my fucking voltage is dropping like a fucking madman. And why is my engine still hot? It's been off for like 2 hours. Oh yeah, definitely, man. The big three will definitely cure my problem. This wire is so small. I don't know how you can see that. Look how small that wire is, man. That's like fucking 10 gauge at the best. And that's going, let me try and measure this out. It's about 4 feet to here, probably. And it's running, looking for the hole in my firewall, since this is my first time. The hole in my firewall. Where would that be? Got a bunch of wires going right here. There's a hole down there. Not sure where that goes. I do not see another hole down there. Do not see a hole over here. Do not see a hole over there. But I have a feeling it's underneath this thing right here, or behind this thing. There's the hoses for the air conditioning. There's wire going behind there, so possibly the hole in my firewall is right in the middle, which would require me removing. Well, there's also a fuse box right here, so maybe there's wires going through here. And why the fuck is that hole in the firewall, man? I might actually have to run a lot more wire than I had anticipated. If it's gonna be like this, I think maybe right there. Because this is a whole bunch of fuses here, and it looks like it's leading into there. And it would ideally be by my dash. Is this a solenoid? Got a shit ton of wires going to it. Or a solenoid, it's got four wires going to it. Varying in size. Well, son of a bitch. Mercedes, where did you put that hole? Because I ain't drilling another one. But it looks like I might have to if I can't find that one. Who knows. I'm gonna have to do a lot more work finding the hole for the power wire to go through. What the hell is that thing? There is so much stuff in this engine that I have no idea what it does. Like this thing right here, I have not a clue what this thing is. This is for the ABS. This whole thing right here is for the ABS. I've never seen that. And there's my fuse boxes, and this is my washer fluid, which needs to be filled. Now that whole thing right there is for the ABS. That would be the brake. Look at that. Look at that fucking brake booster, man. That thing is massive. That thing is so fucking huge right there. My town car had nothing of that size. That was like fucking 10 times bigger. And you have the massive fucking air intake. And this thing, which I believe to be the air conditioning. And this thing, which is the coolant. All that shit over there, I don't know. Let's see if I can look underneath the dash to see where the wires are coming in at. Nope, doesn't look like it. Let's see if it's behind this. Well, what do you know? Score one. Well, there's some wire anyway. And there's a... Right there. There's the hole. I believe. It's hard to see, but I actually don't think that's it. But perhaps it's on the other side. I'm hoping the hole's on this side because the alternator's on this side and the battery's on this side. So anywho, I'm gonna have to measure it all out. Since I don't have a tape measure, that's gonna be pretty hard.